Cars are everywhere. We use them for transportation, sports, and sometimes just for leisure. But we often don't think about what these machines do to our air. Conventional gasoline-powered vehicles produce emissions, specifically carbon dioxide. This is not only harmful to our air, but it is also a greenhouse gas, which is a whole other topic. So our issue is how to improve air quality when talking about vehicles. Well, there's one obvious choice: electric vehicles. These cars produce zero tailpipe emissions and run on pure electricity, which makes them perfect for improving air quality. Yeah, we thought that too. Well, to really compare whether electric vehicles such as a Tesla Model S or Chevy Bolt are really better for the air, we had to do some math. Gasoline-powered vehicles have regulated emissions, which means that they produce more CO2 based on individual vehicle gas mileage. We totaled up the combustion, manufacturing, and production emissions for 5 different vehicles. They averaged around 495.761 grams of CO2 emitted per mile for city and 389.361 grams of CO2 emitted per mile for highway. Alright, so how do you compare cars that have no tailpipe emissions to ones that do? You need to look at how the electricity that powers them is produced. There are many types of energy production methods used around the world today. Coal, natural gas, oil, nuclear, and renewable are the main ones. Each city or state, for that matter, gets their energy in a different way. Let's compare Southeast Michigan with somewhere like Arizona. In Southeast Michigan, coal makes up 46% of electricity power stations, nuclear at 24%, 20% of natural gas, and renewables make up just 10%, with nearly all of that being wind. On the contrary, in Arizona, natural gas makes up 44% of their energy needs, coal makes up 15%, nuclear with 22%, and renewables make up 19%. Natural gas produces 50 to 60% less CO2 in natural gas power plants as compared to coal-burning power plants. Because Arizona uses much more natural gas than we do here in Michigan, this makes them a much more energy-efficient state. Totaling up fuel emissions from energy production in Michigan averaged to around 539.547 grams of CO2 per mile and only 438.297 grams of CO2 per mile in Arizona for electric vehicles. Now we can compare. The emissions for electric vehicles in Arizona were substantially lower on average than the emissions for gas-powered vehicles. However, this was not the case in Michigan. Looking at the data, we can say that if you live in Arizona, sure, go ahead and buy this $68,000 Tesla Model S. But if you live in Michigan, that will only make our air quality worse. Instead, think about carpooling and public transportation. These options offer to transport multiple people in one vehicle and reduce emissions slowly but surely. Or, you can buy a more fuel-efficient vehicle. This one is not as easy or cheap as other methods, but is extremely effective. In our calculations, the most fuel-efficient vehicle we tested, the Chevy Cruze, produced 275.015 grams of CO2 less than the least fuel-efficient vehicle we tested, the Jeep Wrangler. This is a staggering amount, and when multiplied by large numbers of people, buying fuel-efficient vehicles can make a huge difference. While some people need the bigger, less fuel-efficient vehicles for their jobs, if you are in the market for a new car, consider a smaller option, with a miles per gallon in the 30s or 40s. This will work to improve our air quality in Northville and around Michigan so that we can remain healthy and keep our air clean. For more information on how you can help clean up our air, visit our website.